Hello everyone. Our today's topic for discussion is pharmacophore modeling. In this lecture, we will discuss about the types, the generation steps, and the applications of the pharmacophore modeling. Pharmacophore mapping is one of the major elements of the drug design in the absence of the structural data of the target receptor. The tool initially applied to discover the lead molecule, which now extends to the lead optimization. Pharmacophores can be used as queries for retrieving the potential leads from the structural databases, for designing the molecule with specific desired attributes, and for assessing the similarity and the diversity of the molecules using pharmacophore fingerprints. It can also be used to align the molecules based on 3D arrangement of the chemical features or to develop a 3D QSAR models. There are various softwares are available for the pharmacophore modeling, like the Pharmagist, the Farmer, and the Farm Mapper are the free softwares, and the others example include the Catalyst and the Jing Farmer. The pharmacophore concept was first introduced by the Paul Ehrlich in the early 1909. Then the term pharmacophore was coined and defined as molecular features that bears the necessary properties for the biological activity of a drug. Here the phoros means to carry and the pharmaco means the drug, and both of these two words are the Greek word. Then the IUPAC, that is the International Union of the Pure and Applied Chemistry, defined pharmacophores as the sum of steric and the electronic properties that are required for the interaction of a molecule with the target and thus provide the biological activity. In those years, the pharmacophore was understood as chemical or the functional groups on a molecule that are responsible for the biological activity. Pharmacophore models is used to express the 2D and the 3D image of the molecule and to depict the key elements necessary for binding to the receptor. Pharmacophore is a pattern of features responsible for the biological activity of a compound. Coming to the examples, this is an early pharmacophore model for the dopamine D1 receptor agonist. In this pharmacophore model, there is a presence of amine nitrogen, a hydroxyl group, and an aromatic ring. With the distance between the nitrogen and oxygen is 6.8 to 8.3 angstrom. The distance between the aromatic ring and the oxygen is 2.7 to 2.9 angstrom. And the distance between the aromatic ring and the nitrogen is 4.8 angstrom. This model led to the discovery of a constrained analog of a dopamine, that is A68930, a ligand which is highly selective for the D1 receptor, which had been synthesized earlier for a project targeting adrenergic receptor. Here there is an advanced pharmacophore model of the benzodiazepine binding site on the GABA A receptor. In this pharmacophore model, the white sticks represent the carbon atom of the benzodiazepine, the diazepam, while the green sticks represent the carbon atom of the non-benzodiazepine CGS9896. The red and the blue sticks are oxygen and nitrogen atoms that are present in both the structures, both the white and the green structures. The red spheres labeled as H1 and H2A3 are respectively the hydrogen bond donating and accepting sites in the receptor, while the L1, L2 and L3 denotes the lipophilic binding site. So both of these two examples are of the pharmacophore model. Now coming to the types of the pharmacophores. There are two principal approaches of the pharmacophore modeling that are used in the drug discovery process. The first is the structure-based pharmacophores derived directly from the X-ray structures of the protein ligand complexes, which is also known as direct drug design. And the second is the ligand-based pharmacophores derived from the structures of the known active compounds, which is also known as indirect drug design. In the ligand-based pharmacophore modeling approach, novel ligands are designed by using a set of active ligands available. This approach is employed if the target structure is not available. In a similar manner, in the structure-based pharmacophore approach is employed when the structure of the target protein is available. In the ligand-based pharmacophore modeling, first, active ligands are identified by using the literature available or the database search. The data set is split into training set and the test set. Then, features analysis of the training set ligands is done. The common features are detected through the alignment of the active ligands. The next step is pharmacophore model generation, and then the ranking of the generated models. Finally, pharmacophore model validation is performed and the best pharmacophore model is selected depending on the results obtained. In the structure-based pharmacophore modeling, selection and the preparation of the target protein structure is the first step. The second step is binding site prediction. Then, complemental chemical feature of the binding site amino acids and their layouts are identified by analyzing it carefully. After this, the pharmacophore features which should be optimized by the adjusted tools in the programs employed are generated. And finally, the crucial pharmacophore features responsible for the activity are selected. But here the point to be noted is that while the number of the solved 3D protein structures increases each year, there are still a lot of targets which are not available for structure-based modeling. Therefore, ligand-based modeling approaches remain attractive for the researchers. Now coming to the pharmacophore model or the query. A pharmacophore model consists of few features like hydrogen bond donors, hydrogen bond acceptors, the positive features, the negative features, the aromatic rings, hydrophobic features, and their combinations organized in a specific 3D pattern. Here, this is a pharmacophore model in which the hydrogen bond acceptors, hydrogen bond donors, aromatic, cationic, hydrophobic and aromatic rings were shown as features, and all of these features are represented as a sphere as shown in the figure with a radius determining the tolerance on the deviation from the exact position. The features can be labeled as a single feature or any logic combination to combine different interaction patterns within one level. Additional features can describe the forbidden volume interactions. Such pharmacophore features are typically used as queries to screen the small molecule libraries of compounds. Such pharmacophore features are typically used as queries, and in various libraries, all the compounds are present in their low energy biorelevant conformations. Each of these conformations is fitted to the pharmacophore query by aligning the pharmacophore features of the molecule, and the query is composed. If a molecule can be fitted inside the spheres representing the query feature, it is considered as a hit molecule. Often, the pharmacophore query can be too complex to find hit molecules from a given library, and partial matching may be allowed. In such a case, only certain features considered essential for activity are matched. Depending on the situation and the types of experiment, multiple strategies are available to construct the pharmacophore models. either manually or by using automated algorithms. Now coming to the generation steps. In the pharmacophore model generation step, the first step is the pharmacophoric feature extraction. The pharmacophoric feature extraction, in which both the structure based pattern and the ligand based pharmacophore models are used to define the pharmacophoric features. The features which we have already discussed, that is the hydrogen bond donors, the hydrogen bond acceptors, the positive feature, the negative feature, aromatic rings, the hydrophobic features and their combinations. Then the features which are relevant to the pharmacophore discovery are extracted from the input ligands. The selected features from each ligand are combined to form a representation of the whole structure. Then, in the pattern identification phase, the features extracted from different ligand molecules are matched and the pharmacophore candidates are proposed. A pattern is a set of features with their relative locations in the 3D space. A ligand is said to match a pattern if it possesses a set of features and a conformation that are the features can be superimposed with the corresponding locations. The next step is pharmacophore hypothesis generation, in which the candidates are scored and ranked and a lower score indicates a greater possibility that the model has been obtained by chance correlation. Then the last step is the database search, in which the different databases used for the virtual screening, which leads to the lead selection from the hits, which ultimately goes for the experimental screening and the lead optimization. So these are the various steps for the pharmacophore generation. Now coming to the applications in the drug discovery. The applications of the pharmacophore modeling in the drug discovery. The first and the most important application is the lead discovery and the optimization. The pharmacophores can be used as queries for retrieving potential leads from the structural databases for designing molecules with the specific desired attributes. It is also used for the structure activity relationships. A pharmacophore model is trained to discriminate between the active and the inactive molecules, which makes it highly valuable for establishing the structure activity relationships. The another application is the selectivity profiling, for assessing the similarity and the diversity of the molecules using pharmacophore fingerprints. It is also used to develop a 3D QSAR models, which can also be used to align molecules based on the 3D arrangement of the chemical features to develop predictive 3D QSAR models. It is also used in combination with other techniques. The pharmacophore models are also often used together with the other methods to further increase the number of the active molecules in the hit list via the application of a consensus approach. Commonly employed combinations comprise the docking, the shape-based modeling, and the MD simulation. Now coming to the drugs which are developed using pharmacophore modeling. This is a drug molecule which is a novel DNA gyrase inhibitor, which is discovered using pharmacophore-based database search, and this is a 10 times more potent than the novobiosin. This is another drug molecule which have a competitive muscarinic M3 receptor antagonist, which is discovered using pharmacophore-based database search. These are the sources from where the content were taken. Thank you. If you like this video, please do subscribe my channel and share with your friends.